Hello, Aries. Welcome to the beach. We are relaxing and chilling, looking at life, looking at what's going to happen this summer for us. And we have many, many cards, even more than Libra. I don't know, look at them. There's many messages. I'm gonna try to keep it as short as possible, but let's not hurry through it. We start with celebration, having fun, going out, enjoying, partying, drinking, doing who knows what. Who knows what you're doing? Only you know what you are doing. But it seems as if innocent fun, but then we continue with down to the rabbit hole with Five of Cups in reverse. I feel this partying has something to do with grieving. And instead of grieving, you are trying to, be happy, enjoy, just to forget, just to not think about the past, what's happened. And also, this can mean something in the past you are bringing back into your life, but I don't think that thing is very good idea, because fool in reverse is someone who does something foolishly and not thinking through. Okay, if it's like this, then it usually works out for him, but if it's like this, don't be too foolish. Don't take any excess back. Don't be sad about stuff that happened in the past and you already got over it, and again you're bringing it in. Whatever it is that is from behind, it needs to stay behind. But of course, okay, first let's see this one. The Hermit in reverse. This is someone who might be depressed. This is someone who might not want to deal with the issues they have inside. So maybe with all this partying and being happy and blah blah, you are covering that deep inside you have some issues. And you are being called to move on, to move forward, to stop all this nonsense. If you are partying, using drugs, doing sex, taking back exes, and you know they're not good for you, and you think it's going to work out. I don't know if this time it's going to work out. No, it's not going to, and it's not good for you, and you're being called to just move forward, move there into that direction, because there is nothing more for you, okay? And moon in reverse, the moon is going to reveal the stuff that you don't see inside. And the moon is going to tell you what is actually beneath the surface of a happy person. The Five of Pentacles. Maybe you have been gambling, because also fool can tell, can be a gambler. Or maybe you have been buying stuff recklessly just to feel the need inside. Or this can even signify that the poverty time is over. But if you have been gambling and doing crazy stuff, then this might be a really bad card for you. And then there is Queen of Pentacles in reverse as well. And I didn't, when I got those two cards, I didn't want them. I said, there's enough of reverses. Come on, give me some good stuff. And I put them back in the deck and I shuffle, and they came out both again. So I had to take them. So there's something. Yeah, you are compensating for something. You are not. You don't want to go deep inside. Perhaps it hurts too much. But then I got this guy. the King of Pentacles. And this guy is someone who is very stable, who is very down to earth and grounded, and you are being called to ground yourself, get back into reality, take advice from some wise people if you need. But all in all, if you want good things, if you want real party, if you want real good things in your life, come back down. See the reality, touch the ground, and manifest and work from this space, from here. So you're being called to move on because you are stepping into some more solid ground, and with seeing the truth and the reality and knowing how to work with it. Okay, no more foolishness, no more frustrations, anxiety, and all this being covered up because you're not ready to work. Okay, and then I've got next cards from Magical Mermaids. It says, forgive yourself, let the old blame behind, and remember you are a child of God. So whatever you've done, it's done. And you will not bring it back if you've lost it. Trying to revive it and going over and over again, this is not going to help you. And just forgive yourself, because we all made mistakes in our lives. And forgive, let go, breathe. And this card is synchronicity. So there are synchronicities happening in your life for you. Maybe if some people are coming back and then you experience some pain because of them, these are synchronicities to show you that it has to go away. And this card says it's time to move forward. Yeah. It's calling you to move on from whatever was, from whoever and from whatever, just get away from there. And they both have water, moving through water. It's some deep emotions you need to get over. And then you got Father Healing, same as Libra got. And so if a male hurt you, maybe it was about ex-boyfriend or girlfriend, but I don't know. Maybe it was about ex-boyfriend and whatever it was, the love. If it was about love, then this was happening because you had some daddy issues from the back. And this is time to heal those. It was same for Libra, and I guess that's why I've been drawn to do Aries next. I'm not gonna do the signs the way they are in horoscope, but I'm gonna do what I feel. And I felt like I should do Aries, and it has maybe the same message. If you have father issues, you're gonna experience universe to not be... not be abundant towards you. And this is also how maybe Queen of Pentacles feels when she is in a reverse. She wants more, she's not satisfied with what she has. So it's time to heal that, it's time to move on from this. Okay, and then we got one very promising card that says very soon. The thing you're inquiring about will happen very soon and in a happy way. So some good is coming your way to make a relief from all this craziness that is going on in your life. And you are being called to tap into yourself. Go inside. Okay? And while you do that, have courage. Make the first step. Your courage will be on your way the whole time. Yes, just be courageous, be brave. There's no need to be in this denial. It doesn't help you, and it's time to face up. And while doing that, it said, the one card said you have to forgive yourself. And where is it? Yes, and this card says be gentle to yourself. Be gentle to yourself and forgive yourself. Okay, you are a child of God. Which card said that? But yeah, this one. Yeah, you are just a child. We are all just kids learning in this crazy planet. And here is a reflection. Take time to go deep within yourself. Take time to reflect and to get to know yourself from within. Look at what happened in the past. Leave it in the past and stop repeating the same old cycles, because they're not getting you anywhere good, okay? Then I've got a lot of cards from the Romance Angels Oracle deck. And I've got first, I always put the cards as they come out. But I felt like this is the breaking point. So this is the outcome and this is what you need to work on. Okay, you have to release the ties and connections with your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. You know, if you're having reckless sex even with people, or if you keep going back to this person that you know is not good for you, you are, while you're having sex or while you are connecting or even just being around each other, you exchange energies. And if the people are not right for you, you are getting a ton of this negative energy, this stale that is keeping you from progressing. That is why it's important to clear off the old that you know is not working for you. Just to clear the energy out and to, you know, to rejuvenate, to be the new person that doesn't make the same mistakes all over and over again. That's why it's important to take away your excess. And worth waiting for. So that if you are waiting for true love and you don't want to wait for it, you just want to have fun with all the people who you meet, it says it's worth waiting for, okay? It's worth being a little bit by yourself, like connecting with yourself, recovering your energy, not fooling around too much, or even if it's about money, not spending too much. Save a bit of a coin, save a bit of your energy, because it's gonna make you stronger and more powerful and smarter later on, and you're gonna be able to make better decisions when it comes to people and stuff. Okay, sorry, I had interruptions here. We were talking about separation and unrequited love, and love yourself first. You are going to be asked to, you are already being asked to let go of your ex, to let go of whatever happened in the past, and to not fool around too much with too many people. Just go within yourself and be a little alone to heal up. And what happened between you guys is that there was just not enough chemistry to preserve this relationship, so it had to go. And you have to love yourself first, no matter who comes in your life. You need to love yourself first and respect yourself enough to not let people who don't deserve you in. Okay? Okay, no, the compromise doesn't mean to compromise on your values. In relationship, compromise means something else. But many times we mistake the compromise with accepting something that we don't want and that is harming us into our life, and thinking somehow we are going to change that person, or we are going to overcome this and we're going to be stronger than that. No, 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 do not compromise. If the dude is not good, then he needs to go. And then we have the next cards: playfulness, trust, and be aware of the red flags. Yeah? Playfulness. First, let me address these two cards. Like, in order to be able to trust in the person and in yourself, this is the red flags. You need to acknowledge them. This is what I was saying about don't compromise. When you see this is not good, this is not right, do not be fooled and do not be confused. You need to cut the cords when they are not right. Okay? And you need to trust yourself, and you need to trust your intuition. Don't just say, this is not. You see someone looks like he might be a cheater, or he might play you. No, it's not. It's just my thoughts. No, it's not true. You know deep inside what is going on. And you're accepting into your life people who are wrong for you. So this is finishing for you in this summer. And then we go back. We start in playfulness and we end in playfulness. Because it is a time of joy. But we need to know who we play with. The right people to play with we let in, and the wrong people we leave behind. We don't need to play with any fool and any game that comes our way. Okay, we need to be let loose and let love come to us. Do not chase it. Then, like I said, the last cards are when we get to this breakthrough. And when we let this behind, and when we become a bit more playful and light, naturally, not by pretending and by playing just to forget, then this happens. This is calling in your soulmate, and true love and love emotions and relationship from a past life relationship. This is what comes when you give this bit of space for yourself. When you let yourself clean and clear, this is what comes. And because this one came, that says very soon, this is very promising. So what you need to do now, once you've cleared all the mess, you need to state your intent. You need, because it's time to call in your true love. It's time to call in the one that you deserve without compromise. Okay? Whatever you desire in a relationship, whatever you need it. You have the right to need stuff. You have the right to want stuff. You have the right to like and dislike stuff. And this time, it's time to get the real kind of love. And this card might be also a twin flame card. So if you're one of the twin flames, this might be a sign that your twin flame is coming towards you. Otherwise, it's a soul connection, a soul relationship, someone that you are destined to meet, someone that is here for you. Okay? It's not to take from you, but it's to give you and someone who you can be yourself with. And you can let yourself love and be open and be free in this love. You can finally enjoy in love without compromise, without, I don't know, whatever that was. No more of that, okay? This is the time of breakthrough for you, of you realizing the kind of love that you need and that you deserve. And perhaps even that kind of love coming your way. Okay? So I think this kind of completes. Oh, no, wait. Yeah, in the end I've got also this card that says love. You see, I felt like this reading was all about love. And you are magnificent. Love and light. Start to love yourself. There is no better moment than to be in. There is no better feeling than to be in love. But to be in love without reason, to be in love with life. So it's time for you to love and be playful and enjoy, but for all the right reasons, and to first fall in love with yourself and with life. And then all the things that need to fall in place are falling in place. Let go of the toxicity, of the stupidity, of everything that was going on. Okay? So, there is more signs coming, all of the signs that are coming, and check your moon and sun and rising. Sun is probably Aries, because you're listening to this, check your moon and risings. And after this, I will also do what I promised to the singles, that we will look into the future relationship. But first I will do the summer horoscopes. Okay, subscribe here, stay tuned. Thank you for listening. Comment if this resonated. And see you, enjoy your summer. Bye-bye.